Hi there, I'm Terry and this is 5 Minute Velo. I can highly recommend Dylan Johnson's channel on YouTube. This is what he had to say about oval chain rings.
Welcome back to another video. My name is Dylan and I'm a cycling coach at CTS. If you're new to this channel, I make weekly science-based training, race, and gear-related videos. Let's jump into the science on whether or not oval chain rings will make you faster.
And this is what he concluded.
If you like using oval chain rings, then keep on using them. If you don't have them on your bike, then save your money and stick to round rings because they probably won't make you any quicker.
After listening to Dylan's advice, I thought, what idiot would buy oval chain rings? Well, as it turns out, an idiot that can't resist a bargain on AliExpress. And these are the chain rings this idiot bought. They're a set of so-called compact oval chain rings. 50 tooth and 35 teeth, 35 on the inside rather than 34 because of that ovality. I must admit, I only clicked the buy button because, well, they cost me less than £30 for the pair. And they arrived in less than 2 weeks. Compared to some non-round chain rings, they're only mildly oval. The 50 tooth chain ring, for instance, is roughly equivalent to a 52 tooth on the long axis and 48 tooth on the small axis. They claim to be made of 7075 T6 aluminium alloy, which actually is a good choice. I carried out a file test, which suggests to me they are actually 7075. The machining quality actually looks quite reasonable. They appear to be anodized. Apart from the rather over-the-top graphics printed on the surface, they could be mistaken for rings that cost maybe 3 or 4 times as much. The rings fitted onto the chain set quite easily, although I did have to, as expected, adjust the front gear changer to take into account the extra large diameter on the oval chain ring. Once fitted, the chain rings rang perfectly true. The front gear changing with some non-round chain rings is quite poor, apparently. However, this was not the case with these chain rings. Perhaps slightly more hesitant on the up changes, but nothing significant. This might have been because of the only relatively mild ovality, or these hardened steel ramp pins.
As far as the riding feel of these rings is concerned, I can't say I noticed any difference to the round rings.
Okay, I know you want to know about performance, so let's go over to the lab.
I tried to be thorough in my testing. The testing was carried out based on the test protocol I'd previously used. There was one small difference, and that's the physiological input was controlled via power rather than heart rate. I aimed to keep my average power the same for both the round ring and oval ring rides. The ride data can also be found in the spreadsheet, which is also linked in the description. First, I did 2 back-to-back rides around a 40-kilometer moderately hilly route, one ride with the round chain rings and one with the oval chain rings. Let's compare the results. For the round chain rings, I averaged 28.04 kilometers an hour, and the oval chain rings, 28.11. So the oval chain rings were slightly faster. However, the average power was about 1% or 2 watts higher. With 350 meters of climbing, the route was actually moderately hilly. Maybe the oval chain rings help me climb faster. Helpfully, my Garmin gives me a rate of climb metric, the so-called VAM. With the round chain rings, I climbed at 443 meters per hour, whereas the oval chain rings, it was just 425. Again, we don't know if this difference is statistically significant. But the results suggest there's no obvious advantage to using oval chain rings. I decided to delve into this in more detail and collect more data. I already had quite a bit of data based on my 9.5 kilometer training route, and that was using a round chain ring. So I decided to base my other tests on this 9.5 kilometer training route. I re-rode it under the same conditions using the oval chain rings. Because I rode this shorter route many times, I could look at this from a statistical perspective. The 9.5 kilometer training route is almost entirely flat, with only 32 meters of climbing. Again, I matched the bike, rider, and weather conditions as closely as possible. But as I rode this route a number of times, any variation in these parameters should even themselves out. This graph shows the data for the round rings. I rode the course 8 times with an average of 27.35 kilometers an hour. The 95% confidence intervals are 0.15 kilometers an hour above and below that average. Here's that same graph rescaled with the mean and confidence intervals drawn in. Now for the big reveal. I've only managed to do one oval chain ring result before the weather deteriorated, and I've been waiting weeks for the weather to match that of the round chain rings. I've decided not to wait any longer and just publish the result that I've got. In the future I'll do many more rides and update the results. However, based on the one oval chain ring result, as you can see, it's almost exactly identical to the mean of the round chain ring results. Like the longer route, there's basically no difference between the round chain rings and the oval chain rings, so I have no evidence to suggest that oval chain rings give a performance boost. I should have just listened to Dylan. Despite that, would I recommend these chain rings? I think the answer to that is yes, but not because they confer any speed advantage, just because you get some good quality chain rings at a relatively low price. There are no real downsides, apart from the fact that you have a 35 tooth inner chain ring instead of a 34, giving you a slightly higher bottom gear. I hope you enjoyed my excursion into the land of oval chain rings. I certainly did. If you did, please subscribe, as I have more videos in the pipeline. From me, for now, it's goodbye.